this entire presentation based on my recent excavation at Sonauli. This excavation is also produce some unique evidence in archaeological context. I'm calling that the graves of great Indian warriors, the recent archaeological excavation at Sonauli. Sonauli situated just around 70 kilometers away from Delhi. So the entire land is very, very fertile. Re-excavation is needed, in fact. We feel that area is very, very potential for understanding of particularly in Chalcolithic period, amalgamation of Harappan culture and Copper Hoard OCP culture. And there is a lot of sites, and that particular region we already explored, and some of the site excavated also by the archaeologist. So this region is very, very important for understanding of migration of people, migration of Harappan culture, also the OCP and nature of OCP and Copper Hoard culture, and particularly their chronology. Also, we try to understand the chronology of whether the mature Harappan setting is there in earlier, or the OCP, and then overlapping of late Harappan. So there is a very, very complex situation in this area. So this area is needed the meticulous excavation, exploration, and scientific sampling for understanding of settlement pattern. And then, why Sonauli is very, very important? What's the contribution of Sonauli to the world archaeology and Indian archaeology? First and solitary discovery of war chariots in this excavation, and then copper decorated shield, whip and torch, antenna sword with hilt, bow with bone, arrowheads, helmet, highly decorated cot-like coffins. These are the important and solitary example recovered in the grave of Sonauli. Possibly, it is the largest necropolis of Chalcolithic period. And then material culture of these graves can be related with Vedic tradition and later Vedic tradition also. Secondly, the highly sophisticated cultural material found in these graves datable to 2nd millennium BCE, this excavation gives us the new understanding of OCP Copper Hoard culture. Another interesting thing can be researched or studied the technology of making chariot, shield, and other weaponry may travel from east to west also. This is the location of Sonauli. This is the overview of the village as well as archaeological site. In the excavation 2005-06, you can see the very, very rich material, the carnelian beads and another statite and semi-precious stone beams. In this recent excavation, we got burial pit, and that burial pit having all three type of burial system with the coffin, symbolic burial, fragmentary burial, etc. And along with that, we got the sacred chamber, brick structure of sacred chamber, faience and copper pots, habitational area also we have excavated. See the overview of this. This is the sacred chamber, and the series of graves you can see. These are the coffin burials. Another series of coffin burials here, and this is a pit, refuse pit, having a storage pot, as well as the dog burial, bird burial, and the fragmentary burial of a human being also in this pit. We have also done the very, very modern technique for understanding of these objects like X-ray, CT scan, 3D scanning, drone and LIDAR survey, handle XRF to know the metallurgic analysis, magnetometer and GPR survey, and so on. See, the burial number one, this is also a coffin burial. This is lady burial. This is a horned comb having bull head on this. And these are the semi-precious stone, the dagger and dish on a stand we got in this burial number one. This is a silver foil, maybe wrapped over a stick. And within the coffin, all those coffin having very, very lavishly decorated, and just below the coffin, they place many, many important objects like copper utensils, copper tools, weapons, etc. beneath the coffin. See, this is the coffin. All four legs having copper sheathing all around. So all around they have sheathed copper plating, and also in the all around the body they also put the copper decoration all around. So this is the sophistication and the burial. You can see this is a torch, and also this is antenna sword placed in same grave. Just below the coffin, some copper object, channel-like object, and dagger they place within the coffin. This is the overview. This is shield, the very, very decorated shield, technologically very advanced shield. And this is torch, antenna sword. Here we got the copper helmet. See the detail of the type of decoration over the shield itself. This is the inner part of the wheel. You can see the hub and the copper decoration in three row like a radiated sun. This is symbolic burial. We got pair of antenna sword. So maybe the symbolic burial denoting two symbolism of dead. See the hilt, the beauty of hilt. This is antenna. So this is the high technology having the medial ridge in this the both side edge, and this is copper channel. So we don't know the use of the copper channel. So it yet to be understand the use of copper channel. So these are the measurement of the sword. This is another interesting coffin burial. Whole coffin having anthropomorphic figure on the top. So these, the top of the coffin having high relief carving of in the wood. Over it they put the copper sheathing, copper plating with the help of nails. In this we have done the contouring of this area, and the entire lid of the coffin decomposed over the body. This is a skeleton, and this area may have some important burial roots, and the copper object placed just beneath the coffin. See this type of copper object. This is chalice and the helmet and the copper channels. Even the side of the coffin having the floral design all around the coffin. This is the drawing, and just close to that the two chariot placed here itself. One chariot and another chariot. This is the just drawing of the funeral procession of the coffin. The burial number seven, we got three large pot. One of the pot we got the evidence of liquid. This is a twin burial, fragmentary burial, collected the bones. We have done excavation and excavated two burials. Both are coffin burial having four legs. Along with the burial number 10, we got the bow here itself, decomposed bow, along with four bone points. This is the overview. The detail, you can see the inlay, the geometrical pattern of inlay in this leg and this leg. All four legs we have this type of inlay work in the leg. And below the coffin itself, you can see the three row of inlay. One eight shaped shield is there placed below the two leg, in between two legs. This is the, you can see the central chamber, and then periphery also almost 2 feet, another platform, and then brick lining. So may the priest or people standing all around and dead body placed in between for doing some rituals here itself or treatment of a dead body. So the modern asthi jis pe le jate hain, this is the modern cot. You can see here the size of the central chamber. Most important finding of this burial is chariots. We got 3 chariots in the grave. We all know the two-wheeled open vehicle for the war, using for the war, and the lighter also having the fixed axle linked with a long pole to the small yoke of the pair of animals. The axle was attached with a superstructure consisting of platform protected by side screen and a high dashboard. The wheels, pole and yoke are solid and found decorated with copper triangles. See the entire chariot. This is the wheel having the central hub with the nail also. This is outer view of the wheel, and you can see the chaches. The whole chaches is covered with the copper, and this part of the chaches is solid one casted, but this part is having the seating over the wooden structure view. The both the chariot, the one chaches of one chariot and another chariot, the 4 number of pipe is there for the canopy possibly. See the wheel. This is the inner hub of the wheel, the larger one, and another wheel is here for this chariot, and this that chariot. You can see the outer wheel having the similar decoration. You can see the top view of the chaches here, and then attachment for the dice board. The pipe is here, another pipe is here, the dice board fragment of dice board you can see here, the decomposed one. We have done the CT scan of this entire mud, and we got very very interesting carving on this. So the entire dice board is also very meticulously carved. So these are the specification. You can see the whole this is the pole also having the similar decoration of triangular design, the yoke and the pole, and then wheel, sideboard, the entire component of the chariot is preserved, very well preserved. All specification you can see, the measurement etc., the closer view, how they have tied those things, the nails and the attachment for the dice board. And this is the drawing. You can see this is whip, the very very interesting recovery of whip also along with the chariot. You can see here the socket for the tie for the strip. These are the some of the chariot of Mesopotamian, the 4-wheeled chariot, solid wheel, the Egyptian chariot having a spoke, and then Roman chariot very late, around 400 BCE. You can see the shape of the seal in the hand of the Hittite chariot is also very very similar to this chariot. So we have to think more on that, the movement of people from here to, because this finding is earlier than that. And this is another big chariot, maybe the wagon like chariot. Even in the Harappans, we have evidences of a spoke wheel, the cart for carriage, very well see the similar kind of hub also in the Harappan. Harappan also known for the spoke wheel, the toy carts of Harappan. The technologically, the very very similar, but little change, because this is the carrying carriage of people and carriage of material, the cart. But that is the war chariot, very lighter one, and the very advanced technology. In the later on, you can see the in the Sachi Stupa, the similar kind of chariot used in the long time. If we try to trace the Rigvedic references also, there is several references in Rig Veda of a chariot. Particularly the Rigvedic deities like Ushas and Agni also having the chariot. Whether chariot is drawn with the horse or with the bull. So if we see the specification of the chariot, specification of the pole and yoke, that very clearly indicating that horse chariot, because pole is sleeker than the bull chariot and then yoke is shorter, which is only used for the horse chariot. The axle, chechis and wheel, the similarity we can see in the horse chariot, contemporary horse chariot. Even in the late horse chariot of Egypt, of 1700 or 1600 BCE. So you can very well see the development of the chariot, development of the wheel, to the solid wheel, to the spoke wheel. This is solid wheel one. So a little early than that chariot. Very another interesting object is shield. You can see the shield of eight shape, and this is also shield. You can see the possibly the these decoration denoting the war of in front of each other. This is another shield, the similar shield you can see in the world context. This is the result of a CT scan of this particular shield. The wooden small wooden plank they put in the lower portion, and then this side you can see the copper and this round hole having nails to tie the every plank of wood. So if you hit on the shield, that cannot be broke. It's a just little shake, but it's not break. So this technology is very important to understand the making of shield, in particularly in this region. So it's a very advanced technology. Along with this, we got the copper mirror and the comb, decorated comb. These are the gold object. Very interesting object of this. This is the scepter top, made of possibly electrum or the mixed metal like gold and silver. So this is scepter top we got in below the coffin itself. Lot of matte impression we got below that. See the comb and the mirror and gold objects. Particularly the three pots we are talking earlier slide. In this pot we got the evidence of liquid, and a smaller pot below the this bigger pot we got one smaller pot for taking out the liquid from that area. The evidence of liquid, you can see the very well the wavy lines of decomposed liquid. So this is very interesting evidence. Later on we try to do the chemical analysis to understand whether it's a soma or any other liquid. The lot of matte impression, you can see the variety of matte impression, maybe the kusha making the matte. These are the evidence of X-ray. You can see the mud lump. This is the copper nails putting on the another decorated wood. These are the nails and other things. We got the furnaces, copper furnaces also intact in the excavation. So the total area, you can see the many of the furnaces, copper furnaces. These are the pots, variety of pots. This is the oldest helmet possibly of the world. A specification is very, very similar to the another old world helmet. We have lifted all those material from the site to Delhi. So this is another interesting endeavor we have tried to do. We have done the GPR survey and we got a lot of pit in the another field. So there is a lot of area to do the excavation, further excavation for better understanding of this particular phase of Indian culture. This is the entire sequence we try to reconstruct how the funeral process to the last. मृतक भोज तक उन्होंने क्या किया होगा. सो दैट इज वेरी वेरी क्लियर सिक्वेंशियल एविडेंस ऑफ द बरियल इज देयर इन इटसेल्फ. सो देयर इज लॉट ऑफ लिटरेरी एविडेंस ऑलरेडी बिसर एक्सप्लेन ऑल दोज थिंग अग्निदग्धा अनग्निदग्धा एंड ऑल्सो इंटरेस्टिंग वन ऑफ द वर्स ऑफ दिस Rigveda says that one of the warrior buried along with the bow and arrow. That is there in the Rigveda, one of the verse. And the association of birds and animals, the references is also there. Another very interesting matter to discuss that the worship tradition of cults. The image, I have already published the anthropomorphic figure and now we have traces that the different type of anthropomorphic figure having different symbols in the body, even in the physical feature. So that can very easily you can trace with the physical feature and the symbols the whole Vedic deities in the anthropomorphic figure. I can show you some of the example. These are the reconstruction. You can see the great Indian warriors. There is no parallel of these type of tools available in the any of the old world context. See, this is a Varahamukha anthropomorphic, copper anthropomorphic figure already published. Another anthropomorphic figure you can see having the marks, vertical marks on that. This denoting, if you see the figure, the Indra having well, good health and the figure. And also the on the body, you can see the rain marks on the body. If you see the another anthropomorphic figure having Urdhwadhar marks of Urdhwadhar Agni, or leg is very short, a symbolic leg. So the similar tradition followed in the later sculptures in a historical period. So even in the Varuna, you can trace the Varuna, you can trace the Indra, you can trace the Agni, you can trace the Surya also in the anthropomorphic figure. Not only the symbolic depiction, but the physical feature also very similar, which is continued in the later tradition of the sculpture. Thank you. Thank you very much.